Well, hey friends, my name is Jonathan Page. I'm the Director of Connectional Ministries for Innovation and Creativity, and we have just adjourned the 242nd session of the Virginia Annual Conference. You can hear lots of stuff is going on behind me. We've had so much incredible move of the Holy Spirit the last few days here in Hampton, Virginia. I want to tell you a couple of the highlights that we've had while we've been here. First, annual conference is always an amazing gathering of people coming from all corners of the annual conference, from all over the connection, to be able to come together, to be in connection, to be in community, and to share in God's love together. And so that's always something that we celebrate. So part of what we did while we were in session together this year was to have a few different things that took place in relation to business. A couple of highlights from that. We had the approval of a new site for annual conference starting in 2026. That's going to be in Harrisonburg, Virginia. So next year we'll be gathering in June in Roanoke, Virginia. And then in 2026 and 2027, we'll be moving on to Harrisonburg. Another piece of business that was great was about resolutions. We voted to reintroduce resolutions in 2025, but this year a really important thing happened. While resolutions aren't in place yet, the rules were suspended to consider a resolution brought by the Reverend Drew Enns regarding apologies to the LGBTQIA community. And the body had a lot of discussion about this. This went to a vote that was even going to be planned to be a paper ballot. And in the wake of that, this morning at our annual conference session, a group of folks, traditionalists and progressives, from a wide variety of perspectives, came together to propose something called a Commission of Truth-Telling and Reconciliation that's going to be able to come together and do some holy work so that we're not voting on this as much as we are coming to consensus, hearing stories and seeking healing for those who have been harmed by the church, for those who have experienced religious trauma of any kind. Also at this annual conference, we had some new things. We had three teachers, Rodrigo Cruz, Michael Beck, and Wu Kang, who were able to share stories, to share inspiration, and share learning around the three movements that Bishop Sue has been orienting us towards. We also had our first experience with lunch labs, and over these 2 days of annual conference, there were four different lunch labs offered each day, and we had hundreds of clergy and laity come together to be able to find opportunities to learn more about connectionalism and mission. And then, of course, today we had our service of recognition and call, where we had 31 retirees, 14 lay supply, 10 certified lay ministers, 26 licensed local pastors, 3 provisional deacons, 11 provisional elders, 2 ordained deacons, and 9 ordained elders that were recognized as a part of the service of recognition and call. As you can tell, it has been a full time here in Hampton, Virginia. A lot has been going on, and maybe most importantly, people have been in connection. People have been building community. Relationships are being formed and transformed, and we're seeing what God's up to in the Virginia Conference of the United Methodist Church. And so now we leave this place to go get to work, to be in our local churches, to be in our communities, to share the love of God in all that we do, and to anticipate how God might be moving in and through the Virginia Conference of the United Methodist Church. So thank you so much to all of you who attended in person, for all of you who have been following on live stream, for all of you who have been following our social media accounts, however you've been connecting. Now it's time to be in connection. May we go and may we do that well, and may we be an awesome sign of God's love in the Virginia Annual Conference of the United Methodist Church.